Hi, today I prepared a video, a very short video about the thing that we need to be careful when we do the fast Fourier transform FFT. So in this video, I assume that you guys are already familiar a little bit with the concept of the Fourier transformation. I just want to talk about a little bit about the importance of the sampling frequency. Because it's really important and it really changed a lot of your output. So I prepared several sheets that to remind you what is FFT. So FFT is a sort of internal function in MATLAB. I guess you can find the internal function in any kind of programming software. As shown in the description in the MATLAB, the FFT is a DFT, the discrete Fourier transform. So some people frequently ask about what is the difference between FFT and DFT. The answer is that both compute exactly same thing. But the FFT is sort of an algorithm of algebraic resampling of the term in the DFT calculation to make it faster in an implementation. Okay? So this is the mathematical version of the continuous time Fourier transform. Actually, the point is actually simple. This is our original data. Actually, original data can be divided into the wave function and its coefficient, its given frequency. So our if we conduct the Fourier transform in any kind of the programming software, we're gonna get such a coefficient. As a function of frequency, but the continuous time Fourier frequency at the Fourier transformation is actually we have a infinite number of samples. I mean, sampling number is infinite. So we go to the minus infinite to the go to the infinite, and the dt here is I mean is a go to zero. But imagine that in the digital world, we always have some. The sampling numbers, we do not have any infinite samples. Like when the gain, if we gain is given time, then obviously it should be discrete. So that's why we need to use a discrete Fourier transform for the data calculation or whatever about any kinds of application of Fourier transform in software. So this is mathematical version of the DFT. So we certainly have the number and the this is sampling number, and this is starting from the first sample and go to the last sample. So we have an N here. So the fast Fourier transform actually hugely and strongly depend on this N value. How much sample you get you expect and how much sample you input. So in this both case, I just prepare exactly same frequency of the sine wave, but here is a this is 1 pi. So here the frequency is exactly 1, and this one also the frequency itself is just 1, but the sampling number are 5 times different. So here is n equal 20. But here is n equal 100. So obviously the answer, if we conduct FFT, we want to have some one peak in the frequency 1, but because of the sampling number difference, the result is quite pretty much different. So today I want to demonstrate and I want to a little bit discuss how to solve it and how to compensate the effect of the sampling number. So let's switch to the MATLAB. Okay, so now we are in the MATLAB, let's draw a cosine wave, any kind of waveform. Then we start with the giving the sampling frequency. Let's say sampling frequency is 1,000. So we are sampling 1,000 points from out of 1 second. So this is what the sampling frequency mean, and then we can get the time is go to zero from zero to the step is obviously the sampling frequency and go to like 1 second, and we need to subtract the first step. That is the time from 0 to 1 second, and then we're gonna give some the real frequency, I mean in the wave function. So frequency, let's give the 10, and amplitude just 1. Then we can describe a cosine wave. Here is the frequency, given frequency. Here is a 10, and the time. This is our wave, first wave. Then let's plot what is A. Okay, let's conduct experiment. Then this is our graph. So our sampling number is 2,000, and the amplitude is go 1 to negative 1. So if we plot with the time, then we see the time is from 0 second we start and end to the when the time is 1 sec. So if we conduct FFT, Fourier transform of A equal FFT, this is internal function, and just plot. But here is a, you know, the coefficient of the Fourier transform is always incorporates with the complex number. So we use just the absolute value. Let's see what is happening. Okay, this is Fourier transform. So here is now is become as the frequency space, and we have a signal here. Oh, the first peak is x equal 11, and the y, the amplitude is 500. So what happened? This is actually today's question. Actually, we give the frequency is 10. Actually, the x value should be supposed to be the 10, but now it's 11. So do we need to subtract 1? Actually, the problem is coming if we increase the sampling number. If we increase to the go to the 3 sec, then the sampling number goes 3,000, right? Because we are taking the sampling frequency 1,000 per second. So if we go for 3 sec, then the sampling number will be a 3,000. Then let's conduct what is happening. What is happening here is the x value is changed to 31. Actually, so you see here also y value. The amplitude is also changed to 1,500. They are hugely changing because of the sampling number here. So the point is we need to compensate the sampling the effect of the sampling number. So actually I prepared the comparison. You see here I just gave one the exactly same wave that the It's exactly same the frequency. You see here the orange is one wave, and here is the blue is the another wave, but their frequency exactly same, but only the sampling number is different. If the sampling number is different, the first one again, the first one come x equal 11, the second one is coming as I told you 31. So how to compensate this? So let me show you how to do that. Firstly, you know, in the discrete Fourier transform, we have a number is a length of time, right? Then frequency, the real frequency, I mean the real wave frequency is a sampling frequency times n divided by total number of t. So here n will be from 0 to n minus 1. And then we just plot against the real frequency, and because of the frequency effect, I showed you that the amplitude of the Fourier transformed is actually go to like 1,000. So actually this is because we haven't normalized with the sampling number. What happened if we conduct this one? Then you see the when X10 has a value of 0.5. The reason why there is a two peak is actually this is a negative frequency, the effect from negative frequency actually. So that's why the value 1 is divided by 2. So this is right, and the peak position is the 1, 0, which actually shows the f, the given frequency. So let's a little bit change the value like 8, and let's change to the time to 10. Then let's take a look at how look like the original data will be like this. Little bit get more dense, but Fourier transform, yeah, here is we change it to the 8, so we have a value 8 and has a 0.5 value. So always we need to compensate the effect of the sampling frequency, there's a sampling number giving the real frequency, so we need to convert the sampling to the real frequency here. This is we always need to keep in mind. So this is actually the one I want to demonstrate to you, and I hope this video help your understanding. Okay, thank you.